Now, move on to another human organ system, that is excretory system. Excretion is the process of removing wastes and excess water from the body. It is one of the major ways the body maintains homeostasis. Organs of excretion make up the excretory system. They include the urinary system, large intestine, liver, skin, and lungs. Human body works like a machine. Many life processes go on continuously. Through these substances, many harmful substances are produced. These unwanted substances produced from different parts of the body are sent out through the process called the excretory system. If the food we eat is digested, then we get energy. The unwanted food left after digestion is sent out through anus in the form of fecal matter. The urinary system is made up of four organs: kidneys, ureters, bladder, urethra, that work together to help excrete excess waste and toxins out of the human body. Kidneys. There are a pair of kidneys that are purplish brown and are located below the ribs in the middle of the back. They filter the blood and separate the impurities from it. These impurities are sent out in the form of urine. Kidneys remove waste from the blood through tiny filtering units called nephrons. Each nephron is made up of a ball of small blood capillaries called glomerulus. There is also a small tube called renal tubule which drains the urine and joins other tubules carrying the urine out of the kidney to the ureter. Ureters. Each kidney contains one ureter that transfers urine from the kidneys to the bladder. The ureters are shaped like a tube and are about 30 centimeters in length at most. Bladder. The bladder is a triangle-shaped hollow organ located in the lower abdomen. It is held in place by ligaments attached to the pelvic bones. The bladder's walls relax and expand to store urine, and contract and flatten to empty urine through the urethra. Urethra. Urethra is a tube that connects a person's urinary bladder to their genitals so that urine can be removed from the body. In females, the urethra exists on top of the vaginal opening. The urethra in males is longer and it carries urine as well as sperm through the penis. There is also an external urethral sphincter which allows us to voluntarily control urination. Skin is another important excretory organ of the human body. It sends out the wastes in the form of sweat. The doctor who treats the diseases related to the kidneys or renal system is called a urologist. Like other animals, humans also have a system that excretes nitrogen wastes like urea, salt, and water through urinary or excretory system. The urinary or excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys, ureters, urinary bladder, and urethra. Structure of nephron. Generally, each nephron has two parts: Malpighian body, renal tubule. Malpighian body. It consists of a blind cup shaped broader at the end of the nephron called Bowman's capsule and a bunch of fine blood capillaries called glomerulus. These two, Bowman's capsule and glomerulus, together called as Malpighian capsule or renal capsule. Glomerulus develops from efferent arteriole which gives rise to an efferent arteriole. Basically, the diameter of efferent arteriole is less than efferent arteriole. As the efferent arteriole has narrow outlet, more pressure is exerted in the glomerulus. It functions as a filtration unit. Glomerulus, that is accommodated in Bowman's capsule, is lined by a single layer
of squamous epithelial cells called podocyte cells. These podocyte cells are made up of fine pores between them. This allows passage of materials that are filtered out of glomerulus. There are fine pores between podocyte cells to allow passage of materials filtered out of glomerulus. Renal tubule. Renal tubule consists of three parts. First are proximal convoluted tubule, PCT, loop of Henle. Second are distal convoluted tubule, DCT. Distal convoluted tubules, DCT, commences into a collecting tube. Collecting tube forms pyramids and calyces which open into the pelvis. Pelvis directs into the ureter. All the parts of the renal tubule are enclosed by a peritubular capillaries that are formed from efferent arteriole. This peritubular capillaries join together to form renal venule.
Now let us study the mechanism involved in urine formation. Formation of urine involves four stages: glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption, tubular secretion, formation of hypertonic urine.
Click each tab to know more. Glomerular filtration. From renal artery, blood flows into glomerulus under the influence of pressure and due to the narrowness of efferent arteriole. Due to this, it undergoes pressure filtration. Glomerulus filters the waste molecules, urea, salt, glucose, amino acids and water. Blood get filtered through the kidneys about 6 times a day. Tubular reabsorption. The filtrate obtained from glomerulus is also termed as the primary urine. This is almost equal to blood in chemical composition, except the presence of blood cells. This filtrate substance passes into PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. PCT reabsorbs the useful substances present in primary urine, such as glucose, amino acids, vitamin C, potassium, calcium, sodium, chlorides, and 75% of water. Tubular secretion. It secretes the waste products from blood capillaries to urinary tubule. After reabsorption of materials in PCT region, the urine travels through the loop of Henle into DCT, distal convoluted tubule. Here, some other waste products from blood are removed, like urea, uric acid, extra salt, ions of potassium, sodium, chloride, and hydrogen secretes from peritubular capillaries into DCT. This maintains proper concentration and pH of urine. These wastes are collected as urine and are passed into the bladder.
Formation of hypertonic urine. 75% of water content of nephric filtrate is reabsorbed in proximal convoluted tubule and 10% of water passes out of filtrate through osmosis in the region of loop of Henle. Further concentration takes place in the region of collecting tubes in the presence of hormone called vasopressin. This hormone gets secreted only when concentrated urine is passed out.
In the absence of vasopressin hormone, only dilute urine is secreted. Hormone action maintains osmotic concentration of body fluids. Deficiency of vasopressin causes excessive, repeated, and dilute urination, diabetes insipidus. Now let us discuss the remaining parts of excretory system.
Now, let us discuss the remaining parts of excretory system. First, let us learn about the function of ureters. Ureters. In human body, a pair of ureters is present, which is made of smooth muscle fiber. The ureters are whitish, narrow, distensible and muscular tubes. The size of each ureter in adults is 25 to 30 cm long and 3 to 4 mm in diameter. Each ureter arises from hilus of the kidney. From the hilus, the ureter passes down along the sides of pelvis and finally enters at the back of the bladder. The function of ureter is, it carries urine from kidney to the urinary bladder. The movement of urine in the ureter is done by peristalsis. At the entrance of the bladder, the ureters are surrounded by valves called ureterovesical valves, which prevent the backflow of urine. Let us learn about the functioning of urinary bladder in detail. Urinary bladder. The urinary bladder is an organ that collects urine excreted by the kidneys before disposal by urination. If the bladder is empty, then it is in the shape of a pear. Urine enters the bladder via ureters and exits through the urethra. The storage capacity of urinary bladder is 300 to 800 ml. Let us learn the functioning of urethra in detail. Urethra. Urethra is a tube that collects urine from urinary bladder and sends it to the outside. The opening of urinary bladder into urethra is guarded by a ring of muscles or sphincter. The size of urethra is 4 cm long in females and about 20 cm long in males. Its opening is separate in females but is in common with the reproductive tract in males, urinogenital duct. Now, let us learn about micturition. The urine is temporarily stored in the bladder. There are two sets of circular sphincter muscles in the bladder. They are internal sphincter, external sphincter. When the bladder is filling up with the fluid urine, then both these muscles are contracted, so the exit gets closed. But as the pressure of the urine increases, the walls of the bladder are stretched, which causes the upper sphincter to relax. The lower sphincter is under the control of brain, thus the urine can still be inhaled until this muscle is relaxed too. Control of urination is impossible by very young child but is gradually learnt. When the urinary bladder is filled with 300 to 400 ml of urine, then the urge for micturition occurs. However, urine can be held in the urinary bladder till it gets filled up to the maximum capacity of 700 to 800 ml. At this situation, the urge becomes painful and at last leads to voluntary micturition.
Total amount of urine excreted per day may either increase or decrease depending on the intake of fluids like water and fruit juices.
But generally, the total amount of urine excreted per day is about 1.6 to 1.8 liters. Drag and drop puzzle. From the image on screen, identify the parts of structure of the nephron. The first one is done for you. Drag and drop puzzle. From the image on screen, identify the parts of the excretory system. The first one is done for you.